Oddly satisfying doesn't do it justice, does it? Viscera Cleanup Detail is a first-person clean-up game by the South African studio Runestorm, released originally in Early Access in 2014 with the full version coming out in late 2015. The game's premise is that after the hero of a sci-fi horror event is done with his big action part, someone has to clean up the mess, and that someone, Buster Brown, is you. The game tells you who you are, gives you a briefing, hands you a mop, smacks you in the butt, and you're off. Your first glance at the workplace environment will be quite overwhelming, but you gotta start somewhere. That somewhere will likely be making your way to the bucket dispenser to clean your mop. Although I'll try not to leave a trail of mess on the way there. See, you leave footprints if you step on anything too icky, such as blood or viscera. Well, once you reach the dispenser, you'll be introduced to one of the pillars of gameplay, mopping. You mop the bad stuff till shit's clean, and you smack the water. Repeat. Well, that floor itself is clean, but there's all of these body parts and their respective insides lying around. Now you gotta find a method of disposal. This will likely be just a big old incinerator, but it can change depending on the map. For example, launching stuff into outer space seems to do the job quite well. Don't think you'll get away with just disposing of the squishy red stuff, though. All of this trash, glass shards, bullet casings, notes containing pleas for help of the now incinerated victims, all of that? Trash. Dispose of it. Before you get a bit too excited, there are a few things you should not dispose of in any circumstances, such as barrels and boxes. There'll always be a designated place on the map to store them in. Neat organization being optional, of course. And these pen drives you find near the victim's corpses. You want to be taking them back to the level's entrance and shoving them into the sponge out machine. We'll talk a bit more about what that does later. For now, back to the dirty work. Instead of carrying the jibs one by one, you can vastly improve productivity by utilizing one of these yellow bins. You can get them at these green dispensers. Now you can quickly collect all of the nearby waste and take it in bulk to the place of disposal. Remember not to just toss the bin inside as well. You can rotate it and dump all of its contents, leaving the bin intact, meaning you can make use of it again. Efficiency. You should be able to find this laser gun lying around somewhere in the level. You can use it to make corpses more manageable. In other words, turn them into this big, gooey red ball. Not only is it more space efficient, when you toss it around, it doesn't leave blood splatters. Furthermore, the gun is also used in the removal of numerous bullet holes scattered around the map. You should watch out for these, as they can be quite hard to spot, which leads us to our next tool, a sensor device. This will help you find any remaining small pieces of debris, trash, or blood splatters you might have missed. It's extremely useful when you're just about finished and need to do a once-over, just to make sure. Around the map are these empty first aid slots mounted on the walls. To refill them, find the vending machine and get a first aid kit. Here, you can also get other stuff to help you with your job. For example, if a room is a bit dark, get a lamp. Some of the items it'll sell will be specific to certain maps, like these vials of acid you can use to remove the protest for health and safety, amongst other rites sprayed and painted on the walls by your now ex-co-workers. In some of the levels, you encounter dirty stuff on places too high for your mop to reach. This is where this lift thingy comes into play. Just hop on top of it and smack the up or down button. Beware though, it can malfunction and jam. That being said, all of the previously mentioned pieces of kit that are available to you can and likely will malfunction. The laser gun can overheat and cause a mess, the bean dispenser can for some reason spit out various body parts, and so can the bucket dispenser. Though the latter has a tendency to also produce some more unfortunate items that can lead to various undesirable workplace incidents. And speaking of those, you can die in this game, though death doesn't really mean that much. You're quite disposable, so they just hire a new janitor for the job and you take control of them, even getting to clean up the squishy bits of your past self. As you clean the place, you start to piece together what happened. Maybe they dug up something that they shouldn't have. Maybe they created something that they shouldn't have. Maybe they said something that they shouldn't have. But remember, you're just a space janitor. Keep your head down, don't ask questions, and try not to think too much about it. Trust me, that'll help you sleep at night. All of these little details on what happened and how it happened and what caused it to happen gives each level a good amount of flavor and makes each one of them unique. Which is good, because you won't find much variation in the core gameplay loop from level to level. When you're done with a level and hopefully satisfied with your work, you should make your way back to the level's entrance and use the punch-o-matic. It'll ask you about your janitorial performance and give you a handful of options. As for this one, you just complete the level normally, and if you did a good job, you should get a 100% rating. As for the top one, well, it gives you paperwork. I know this doesn't sound exciting, it's not. It's actual paperwork. Remember when I mentioned you should bring each of the pen drives you find near the corpses back to the punch-o-matic? Doing that will file each of them in the paperwork screen, and you'll have to fill out some details on the circumstances surrounding them. For example, cause of the incident, where the game lists a myriad of lovely ways in which the victim could have suffered through. This part of the game is option and only for those who are seeking to get completion ratings above 100%. I usually do it because I am, well, as they say, a sick fuck. But I'd never in a million years recommend this part to anyone. After punching out, you'll be taken to the office. In this place you can check your completion rate, read reports of what happened, collect items from your janitor's trunk, etc. Your office should be the same throughout your career, unless you get fired. This happens when you get a below 70% completion rate on a level. It'll just reset your office back to default. Graphics-wise, this is an Unreal 3 game. It looks like one, it feels like one, it runs like one. Like I said previously, all of the levels feel pretty unique, and this is partly due to the different assets and color palettes used. The soundtrack is so bad it's good, I guess? There's something about it that makes it funny to listen to. Might be how upbeat it is compared to the context of what your job is. Oh, and one more thing I should mention is that multiplayer is a thing. It's quite good, it works quite well. Local split screen is a thing. Though the physics do get a bit fucky, even if your ping is good. You especially notice it when you have a bunch of stuff in the bin and begin carrying incinerator. Ugh. Some people already knew this game from the Christmas special level that went slightly viral with YouTubers back in the day, but they just discarded it as a meme and never looked into the actual game. It's a shame, I mean, I know this game's premise is a hard one to sell. When I first saw it, I thought, that's fucking dumb, why would anyone play that? But then I did, and I still am, so maybe you should try it too. The Christmas edition is really cheap. Use it as a demo to see if the core gameplay loops resonates with you. If it doesn't, just get a refund. But hey, if you find yourself scouring the floorboards looking for hidden bits of late Santa's Little Helpers, then consider getting the actual game. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a lovely day. Bye bye.